We came to Al-Assad to share our eternal gratitude for everything you do to keep America safe, strong, and free.
President Donald Trump has made a surprise visit to American troops in Iraq, his first trip to a war zone since taking the Oval Office. But it remains unclear whether or not this secret visit was added before or after it became clear that the government would be shutting down indefinitely in the middle of a messy political battle over border security, which has yet again become the focus of another tragedy. On the same day, the body of a 7-year-old Guatemalan girl who died in U.S. Border Patrol custody was laid to rest. A second Guatemalan child is dead after being detained at the U.S.-Mexico border. U.S. Customs and Border Protection says the 8-year-old boy and his father were in custody on Christmas Eve when an agent noticed the child was coughing and appeared to be sick. He was taken to a New Mexico hospital, diagnosed with a common cold, and released. But the boy was transferred back to the hospital hours later, where he died on Christmas Day.
You know, we just left a shelter where there are a number of little children, one of whom is 3 years old, has a fever. Some of these kids, when they get here, who've been traveling for 2,000 miles, they really need some help. They need medical attention. They need us to be looking out for them. Let's make sure that they're okay. Let's make sure that they're with their families. Let's make sure that they get medical care. They pose no threat to this country.
It's just the latest example of the life and death challenges faced by thousands of Central American migrants attempting to cross the southern border. CBP has now announced several policy changes, including medical checks on every minor in its custody, with a focus on those under 10 years old. Earlier this month, 7-year-old Jacqueline Cal died from a combination of cardiac arrest, brain swelling, and liver failure while being held by U.S. Border Patrol in New Mexico. Her Christmas Day funeral left her mother so overcome by grief, she could not bear to attend.
You have illegal people coming into our country. We can't do that. We don't know who they are. I don't want them in the country. The only way you're going to do it is to have a physical barrier, meaning a wall.
Her death has raised questions about how migrants are treated in the hands of authorities, prompting this promise from the Trump administration last week.
You have my commitment to ensure that all of our detention centers take good care of those in our care.